of our Healthy Start and Orthotain medical review for doctors. This is going to be an opportunity for you to also receive CE credits. So fasten your seatbelts, because what you're about to learn is something that could be practice changing, life changing for the families that you affect. And presenting today is Dr. Amanda Wilson, DDS, MDS, orthodontist, and she is from Hawaii. So by the time we get to the end of this, you will see how that you are going to be able to have that CE credit and an invitation to go beyond that. We think that you probably will be interested. I'd like to start out with just a minute on the company that you're learning about. What's the backstory here? Who's behind this? Well, the world changer, Dr. Earl Bergerson, is a board certified orthodontist. He has spent 50 years. In fact, in August, he'll be recognized for that 50-year experience for the world and what he has provided to change so many lives. He is the inventor of the Healthy Start treatment system and also the CEO and head of Orthotain, which was originated just about this time in 1967. They just observed that 50-year anniversary as well. They've treated 3.5 million children around the world. Dr. Bergerson taught for 25 years at Northwestern Dental School. That's where our event in August is going to take place, and we're invited. He has also delivered over 500 seminars himself, and he is still speaking. He'll be speaking on the West Coast in some of the upcoming seminars we'll share. He has 80 peer-reviewed articles, 80 monographs, and he is the most prolific patent developer since Thomas Edison. Right now, he has 514 U.S. and international active patents in effect. And the appliances that you're going to learn about are both orthodontic and orthopedic. They are FDA approved. They are the equivalent of a Class II medical device and the Health Canada certification. There are no BPAs, no silicone, no latex, and the cases themselves are antimicrobial. You see that we are IOS certified, and everything here is American made, although we are working in 37 countries and counting. They were just in Germany a few weeks ago. 60 distributors applied for distribution for their communities. We'll probably take on another 10 or 12 distributors. But today I told you that you're going to be hearing from Dr. Amanda Wilson. She's a native of San Francisco, and she obtained her dental education from UCSF Dental School, her Master's of Dental Science and Orthodontics Certification, University of Connecticut Health Science Center. She practiced clinically for 10 years in the San Francisco Bay Area, which of course is where she grew up, and during that time she had thousands of orthodontic cases. So her experience really lends itself to what she's doing now in her calling to teach and mentor. She's transitioning from the corporate dentistry and had where she had dedicated several years as a dental director and consultant and speaker to both the national and international dental and orthodontic companies. Well, she's doing the same thing for us now, because she really recognized that early intervention is an area of need. There is a void in the dental industry in the field of orthodontics, and within early orthodontic intervention, Dr. Amanda became a clinical instructor for Healthy Start and Orthotain. She, of course, with us, hopes that you will be a part of the Healthy Start team, creating awareness about early intervention and how early screening and treatment can often eliminate the future necessity of costly and painful, time-consuming process in orthodontic surgery and at patient risk. So currently, give you just a second here, a profile of what Dr. Amanda is doing. She lives with her family in Honolulu, Hawaii, but she travels internationally. She is the consultant for a lot of dental practices. She likes to meet her clients and teams to talk about the advantages of early orthodontic intervention. But on her personal time, she's happily married, and she enjoys surfing and hiking. She's involved with the Brownies and the Girl Scouts and the USA Swimming Official. She's got kids that excel in both of those areas. And should the occasion arise, let me tell you that she is bilingual in German. So we have something for you very special, worth holding on to the end for. So stay with us. Dr. Amanda is going to be with us today for 45, maybe 55 minutes to talk about the presentation that she's developed for you. She's also going to be live and could be with you on the West Coast in San Diego, in Austin, and also in Kona. If you're planning a very special trip, she can meet you there, right there in Hawaii. But right now, I would like to turn it over. So Dr. Amanda Wilson, go ahead and share your screen.
Sure. All right. Here we go. Thanks so much, Kathy, for that awesome introduction, and aloha to all the doctors and teams on today's webinar. I'm super thrilled that you're going to be joining me here today for an introduction to Healthy Start in Orthodontics. Just a quick disclaimer, the videos and opinions in this presentation are those of myself, the author, and not necessarily those of Healthy Start Orthotame team. So thanks so much for the understanding. So let's take a step back in time. I know you all want to get to the meat, the bread and butter of the presentation, but let me give you a little bit more background so you can understand the speaker and understand where I come from, and I think the content will make more sense. 2 decades ago, Align Technology launched an innovative new concept in the orthodontic industry, which has revolutionized teeth straightening around the world. Meanwhile, quietly in Chicago, Dr. Earl Bergeson, the Healthy Start orthodontic team, were launching their own quiet orthodontic innovation. To date, over 3.5 million cases have been completed. Can you believe that? The Healthy Start early orthodontic system uses eruptive guidance technology to gently direct teeth as they erupt, as opposed to applying heavy forces after they are fully erupted, once the teeth are in inclusion. Those guidance-based mechanics eliminate risks of unhealthy side effects such as root resorption and discomfort, and in most cases, retention is unnecessary past age 12. The appliance system is only worn at night and occasionally 2 hours during the day during screen and homework time, making compliance super easy. In addition, with low lab fees, and let me tell you, the lab fees are super low, like around $600 to $700, you know that's low, your ROI or return on investment can make the system a successful addition to your practice. And to boost, every time you finish a case, the average referral rate is between 4 and 10 referrals per case completed. Where else can you get that? Nowhere right now. So I wouldn't do the appliance justice if I didn't take a moment to explain the biggest ROI of all, the sleep disordered breathing and systemic benefits. And if you don't think orthodontics affects the overall total body health, and how you as a clinician can help kids not only look better, but also feel better, you will after this webinar. Parents are raving about it, especially on social media, whether you're on Snapchat, Pinterest, Insta, or Facebook. They're all over talking about Healthy Start as a new and the best way to treat orthodontics early, and how Healthy Start appliance is improving both the smile and the well-being of their child. Not sold yet? Well, we'll explain it to you more later clinically and show you a lot of before and after slides. So this is my kiddos here. This is Evan and Olivia, and they're amazing. And I didn't quite get them started on the Healthy Start appliance system early enough. I'll explain why, how it's important to start really early. The ideal time is kind of in the 4 to 7 age range, but we're finding many other friends and cousins to start Healthy Start treatment early. So I want to tell you a little story about how I got here. So for me, it all started in 1999 when a group of young entrepreneurs came to my dental school, UCSF, to tell us about a new little orthodontic company they were launching called Align Technology. Have you heard of it? Probably yes. Well, at the time in 1999, nobody had. So from that day forward, I knew I wanted to be an orthodontist. I had to study hard, just like you guys. I was one of the earliest orthodontists to be trained a few years later and to take my course. And you know, at that time, Align Technology Invisalign was only available to orthodontists. Of course, that changed. So see, Invisalign at the time was the wild, wild west, a concept so new and so different that it was totally bold for us to embrace it. Now, those early adopters who embraced it and all its flaws, and there were many a generation ago, are now professionally sitting totally pretty and doing very well. But it takes a very special doctor initially to take those first lonely steps in the opposite direction from your peers. So, for example, when I took my Invisalign course, I think it was 2002, maybe 2003, as a second-year resident at UConn, our program director, and I won't name him, but you all know who he is, actually told us if he caught us going to the course, he'd throw us out of the residency program. Of course, we were told that all the time for everything, but I don't think he was kidding, but many of us took it anyways, and we just flew out to San Francisco for the weekend and took red eyes back and forth, and we took it, and we're super glad we did. So 2 decades later, if you're interested in becoming a Healthy Start provider, please stay tuned for the exciting announcement at the end of the live webinar from Kathy. Also, please feel free to raise your hand. Depending on your screen, it's either in the top left-hand corner or in the bottom. If you have any questions, and our team members will contact you after the presentation to answer your question or concern. So kick back and relax. Grab that cup of tea, or for me, a coffee. And for those of you in Europe, and I know there's many of you, get a glass of wine for me and learn more about orthodontics, sleep disorder, breathing. Thanks. Let's go ahead and begin. All right, so we're going to do something fun here, and I love my presentations to be interactive. So we're going to do kind of a virtual consultation. I want you all to pretend like you're in your office. Pretend like you're seeing these kids. These kids are walking into your waiting room, okay? And they're just walking in, brother and sister combo, and you're looking at them. You know as soon as a patient walks in that waiting room, as soon as that patient walks into your chair, you're observing them. You're making assumptions. You're making diagnoses already. What do you see? Take a few minutes, even if you're not an orthodontist, even if you're a distributor or anyone in the orthodontics industry, an assistant, I know you know what you're talking about. I know what you know what you see. So grab a piece of paper, grab your iPhone, take some notes. What do you see? What concerns you? Don't worry. We're going to circle back to this at the end, and I'll tell you what I see. And if I've done my job right on this presentation, you're going to see things totally different. And like Kathy always says, once you know stuff or see stuff, you can't unsee it. Your entire concept, your entire vision of treating as an orthodontist and treating patients may change just in this 55 minutes. Here's some more patients for you, these ladies right here. Take a few notes. Don't worry, we'll come back to it. All right, well, I know Kathy already gave us a great intro about Dr. B, Dr. Earl Bergeson. He's the inventor of the Healthy Start orthodontic system, and he's amazing. And if you've never had an opportunity to hear him speak, you need to schedule it right now. Let us know. We'll let you know where he is, because he's totally inspiring. I know he inspired me. So Dr. B, as we affectionately call him, is a total innovator. And if you didn't know, he is the second highest patent holder in the United States after Thomas Edison. I can guarantee you no other orthodontic company in the world can say that. He's constantly coming with new and innovative ideas. And right now he's already on his fourth generation of the Orthotain appliance system. We call that the Healthy Start system. And it is incredible. And it's totally changed the way I practice orthodontics. So that brings us to why you're all here today. You guys are all here to learn more about our early treatment or our eruptive guidance, e.g. comprehensive treatment, phase one treatment, or habit intervention. So let's go ahead and get started. Habit intervention, that's the first step to all Healthy Start appliance systems. It's number one. I know you're thinking, gosh, I do habits already. I know everything about habits. I'm amazing at habits. I'm an orthodontist. Hey, I thought I was too. Let me tell you about a little bit how it went. All right. So all habits to me were thumb and finger sucking, and that's it. And that's all I screened for, pretty much. I'm kind of embarrassed to say that now that I know so much. But like I told you, once you know stuff, you can't unknow stuff. And I had a couple tricks, and I can go into that another time if I see you guys in person. But I thought I was pretty savvy about eliminating habits, but I wasn't. It was pretty terrible, actually. And what I started finding later is that there was a lot of habits I didn't know were occurring, and I'm not just talking about tongue and thumb habits. It's way more than that. It's way more complex than that. And all my great ortho cases, sometimes, not all, but many of them, were getting unraveled. The outcomes weren't as good as I thought. The retention, the outcomes 10 years down the road was not as good as I thought because I didn't diagnose and treatment plan and eliminate fully all the habits that were occurring. I could have done things totally different, and that's why you're here today. So let's talk about habits. What type of habits should we be keeping an eye out for? What type of habits should we be eliminating? Well, it's not just thumbs and fingers. It's tongue thrust and speech problems, abnormal swallowing. We talked about tongues and fingers, mouth breathing. That's a big one. We'll get there later. And of course, the position, the resting position of the tongue. So what does the Healthy Start Habit Corrector do? The Habit Corrector, and again, this is just a snippet today. This is going to be a 45 to 55 minute snippet of everything you'll learn at the comprehensive course. Our certification course is mind-blowing. And I know you think you've heard it all, done it all from as an orthodontist. You have not. You're going to sit in on this course and you're going to be dumbfounded at how much you do not know and how valuable that 2 days can be to improving your patients, to treating patients early, to eliminating habits. There's also a live clinical day where one afternoon, the Saturday afternoon, we screen and we use media to bring patients in from all over the community. So for example, if you go to our San Diego course in a couple of weeks, we will have patients in the area from San Diego. Now, if you're lucky and you actually have a practice in San Diego, you just may hit gold, because there's going to be patients that come in hearing about us from social media, hearing about us from the media on TV, looking for solutions. They're not looking for Invisalign team. They're not looking for brackets and wires. They're looking for the Healthy Start appliance system. They're already educated and they're looking for a provider in your area. So if you get lucky, you may come home with already your first few cases ready to go. And that happened to us last month in Houston. One of the providers came home with a bunch of patients. We were already setting up appointments at the session. That's incredible. Where else can you do that? So Habit corrector is the first stage in every single Healthy Start treatment plan. And these treatment plans are customized. It works no different than it does with some of your other aligner systems where you submit and you get a treatment plan, right? They tell you step by step what to do. Same thing, but it's going to be fundamentally different because it's going to reach out in new ways and new avenues of dentistry that maybe you weren't incorporating into your orthodontic treatment plans. So what's it going to do? It's going to correct basically every possible kind of habit that you know it occurs and every kind of habit that you maybe didn't know was occurring because we're going to find out about it. Mouth breathing, snoring, sleep disordered breathing, sleep deprivation, any kind of habit, tongue position, swallowing, tongue thrust, finger sucking, open bite, speech problems. Now remember, these habit correctors are customized for the patient. So we size it, we take a look at the bite, we help you find the right fit of the habit corrector and different modifications depending if they have open bites or over bites. So it's all perfect fit for the patient. Ultimately, the goal is to get the arches before you start the ortho treatment, the perfect width. If you get to the perfect width, then the teeth come up really, really nicely, right? So not waiting till all the teeth come in or we're in mixed dentition and then expanding the arches, doing it before the permanent teeth come up. And it's totally non-invasive. You're only wearing it at night. It's really easy to get used to. I know you're thinking, oh my goodness, my patients have to do something at night. It's easy. We talk you through it. We teach you all the tools and tricks for compliance. So also for people or patients, you know, there's tons of patients that have thumb and finger habits, and there's adults that have it too. And I, you know, you see them all the time, and you really get to know the patients. You really dig in. You find out adults have them too. You see it all the time. You're going to sub out. It's a very hard habit to break, and it's very, very traumatic for the child and for the parent. You're going to sub out that unhealthy habit for a healthier habit. They're going to be able to replace their thumb or fingers with the appliance that they're going to wear at night or in times of stress or when they watch TV or whenever their trigger point is. And it's this appliance is totally fine. You can wear it. It can't do any harm for wearing it. It's going to keep the tongue in the correct position to swallow correctly and also expand the arches and eliminate any of the damage that's already been done. All right. So you kind of get the idea about habits. And remember, the habits component of our actual lecture in our two-day course takes almost 2 hours. It's an hour and a half, and I did it last time, so I know that. So I literally just condensed an hour and a half down to 5 minutes. So bear with me. If you want to know more, we'll teach you more at the course. Now we're moving on to everything you want to know. How to straighten teeth using EG. This is 100% different than your bracket and wires and aligners. Nothing like it, not at all the same. Yes, it's straightening teeth, but not in the same way. So what can it correct? Well, it pretty much corrects almost everything, and we'll go over into it. And I know you all are just dying to raise your hands and you're going to disagree with me, but keep in mind we have 50 years of research and 3.5 million cases. And if you hadn't heard of Healthy Start Orthotane, well, it's always been there. It just maybe didn't have a million to billion dollar marketing budget, and that wasn't what they were focusing on. This is just my opinions, like I said at the beginning. They were focusing more on getting the product right and taking care of patients and supporting their doctors than spending and keeping their lab fee and their overhead low so that it was affordable for everybody. So it's going to correct open bites, overjets, overbites, small lower jaws, and constricted maxillas. Okay, so I'm freaking out with the slide now, so don't worry about this. But I know you all are looking at the going, having flashbacks of first year or second year dental school. You're seeing a histology slide. You're probably not happy about this, unless you're a scientist. But in any case, let me kind of explain why I have to show this. You have to, in order to understand the EG system, you have to understand histology. So you remember you sat in histology class back in the day. If you were like some people I know, you were sleeping in the back. But if you're like me, you're the nerd in the front taking notes. So now those notes have come to help me out. So, okay, taking a look. So we know that what happens when teeth erupt. When teeth erupt, you get all these PDLs. Remember all these PDLs? We got your circumferential fibers, your transeptal fibers. There's a zillion of them. You remember, right? We know those are really, really strong. We know those are strong from ortho because anytime we try to move a tooth, it's going to bounce back. It has elastic memory, right? That is like the bane of orthodontics, relapse, right? But it's also, you can look at it as how it makes ortho most profitable, right? Relapse, because relapse supports our practice. But any patient that's going to have brackets and wires or aligners is going to have to wear retainers for life, or they're going to have relapse and get another treatment. Okay, yeah, I know this is a big profitable part of your practice, but think of it a different way. Hey, I know for me, I've had braces twice, aligners once. It's not that fun to have treatment as an adult. And I'm married to my retainers. I hate them. I mean, they're comfortable and I made them and everything, but if I didn't have to wear them and I could keep my outcome, I would be much happier. And gosh, when you travel, it's such a hassle. And I know that shoot, I'm in the orthodontic industry. You know, I probably have the least stress. I know so many parents who have high schoolers. They go off, kids go off to camp. Shoot, my own kids are going off to camp and I worry about retainers for one of mine. Same thing with kids going off to college. It's very stressful for families. And if there's a way that you could eliminate that stress and not have to worry about relapse, it would be a huge blessing. And your patients would be very thankful that you gave them that option. So the way that these fibers, and we call them in Healthy Start, we call them gingival fibers or collagenous fibers. But once the tooth fully erupts and gets up into occlusion, these fibers fully mature. They're not fully matured and they don't have all those elastic properties until the teeth have fully erupted and gone up into occlusion. Okay, so initially when you're first, your teeth are still erupting, you don't have that kind of memory there. So with that being said, the way the EG system works for the Healthy Start appliance system is that it works fundamentally different. You're gonna create the space with a habit appliance, okay? You're gonna get the ideal amount of space so that the teeth will hopefully come up straight to begin with. Then once they start to come up straight, you're gonna provide a matrix or kind of a guide so that the teeth come up in the perfect spot. So essentially, someone who was predisposed or would have had crooked teeth now has more space and their teeth were guided to come up straight. You're going to use the patient's or the child's own natural forces. There's no external force that's provided. You're just guiding the teeth up straight because you already created enough room. Or in the case of, you know, with a kid that was predisposed to way too much spacing, you may have constricted the arches a little bit ahead of time. So that's basically how it works. So now the teeth come up straight, the fibers get totally programmed once they're in occlusion. They get programmed to think the teeth are straight, and they are straight. And guess what? You never ever have relapse. Just a few exceptions, and I know orthodontics is all about exceptions, but we'll dig into that into the actual course. But the vast majority of Healthy Start EG cases that are started early, the 5 to 7 range before the permanent teeth come in, do not need retention. That's incredible. Now don't freak out now, because I know you're thinking, gosh, she's taking away a big portion of my client base, of my patients, no retention, no relapse. What am I going to do? Hey, you're going to have a heck of a lot of relapse cases already. This would take generations to get everyone to do it. I mean, look how much it took Invisalign, an entire generation, to really change the mindset, change the opinions. It was not even, no one even knew what it was 20 years ago. So give it time. By the time this really takes effect and everyone's using Healthy Start and there's no relapse, you're going to be gone and your practice will be sold. So don't worry about that. Right now, I think it's a huge opportunity because look at it. Your patients right now are what? They're 7 to 12, right? Or 7 to 15 or 7 to 18 and a few adults, something like that. They start at 7, right? Vast majority. I know mine started at 7 because I had this pamphlet in my that I used to give to every single GP that said, AAO says I should start seeing patients at 7. So I told my front desk, I don't see patients till they're 7 and they have their 6s in. Because all my appliance anchored off the 6s. I had no idea what to do with a 5-year-old that had all primary teeth, that had a malocclusion. I just didn't know what to do. Well, guess what? Now you do. Now you can treat this entirely new age group. And let me tell you, the demographics say, you know, sociology says there's a ton of patients in the 2 to 6 age range. Tons of them, potential patients. You don't take them, somebody else is, because there is stuff you can do. And no, this isn't right for every single family. There's going to be families that love their braces. They love their braces at 12. They want the colors, and that's great. But there's people that will want it. So why not offer it? All right. So what type of patients are best for this kind of treatment? Well, what kind of patients are not best? And we'll get to those. But there's many more indications for treatment. So we'll go over this. And keep in mind that Healthy Start treatment can go from 2 to adult. But ideal patients for ideal outcomes are going to be patients who have started before their permanent teeth come in. So what age is that? Well, you know, that can vary. It could be 5, it could be 6, it could be 7. So we're gonna give the 5 to 7 age range. You can start later, but you may not get as perfect, you may not be able to treat as complex of cases, and or you won't be able to take all the non-retention benefits of it. So either way, it's still fine. So what can we do? Any type of crowding, any type of overbite, any type of overjet, rotations less than 90 degrees, but you guys are smart. You guys know how to use auxiliary. So if it's more than 90, you can do a little sectional appliance. You can use buttons and power chain. You know how to do that. I'm not worried about that. TMD problems, maxillary spacing, anytime. Open bite, as long as it's habit related, not skeletal. Gummy smile, as long as there's an overbite to intrude. Cross bite, any type. Or sleep disordered breathing issues. Wow. If you take a look at your 2 to 6 age range on any patient, I guarantee you it's about 95% of kids. Contraindications, of course. closed lock TMJ, don't want to see those. Do examine your TMJ. Class 3 skeletal, cast open bite skeletal, or syndromic class cleft lip and palate. Although, I can say, since we're talking about special needs patients, I would highly recommend you trying the Healthy Start Appliance system for spectrum kids, autistic spectrum kids. Fantastic for these type of kids. And I want to classify them, but I am, because it's just, it doesn't overload the sensory. They're very compliant. They're very comfortable with it. For some reason, it just fits, and we get great feedback about this appliance system working with this niche of patients. And in certain areas of the country, I think it's an amazing way you could differentiate your practice. So highly recommended. All right, biomechanics. We kind of already talked about this. So basically, fundamentally different. It's not applying an external force to a tooth that's already erupted in occlusion. It's providing initially enough space, expanding the arches to the exact right width, so the teeth will come up straight without having too much space or too little space, and guiding the tooth using the patient or the child's own natural eruptive forces. No external forces is given so that the tooth comes up straight and in occlusion. So you guys are smart, so I know you're about to, I'm thinking what you're concerned about. You're thinking, wait, I'm starting this kid at 5, 6, or 7, and I'm treating them till 12? What the heck is she talking about? That's ridiculous. I won't make any money off of this. Yes, you will, because it's totally different. Think about how much chair time, think how much doctor's chair time is spent on your bracket and wire patient, or even less so, your aligner, Invisalign team patient. Okay, average appointment, band and bond appointment. Now you have your activation appointments, all the way to debond appointment. Add it up sometime. And if you're not sure, add it up. How much, what's your ratio of assistant to doctor time? All right, you know, everyone's going to be slightly different, but I guarantee you, it's going to be less than the Healthy Start. Healthy Start, yes. Some people and some doctors will see them only for phase one. They'll charge out your phase one treatment code, your ADA code. Some doctors are going to see them for comprehensive. That's ultimately totally a choice, how you want to charge it out, how you want to integrate it into your practice. But regardless, over 90% of Healthy Start appointments are assistant time only. There is nothing to glue to the teeth for most cases. There's nothing going on like that. There's nothing to break. It's really easy. It's mostly just rah-rah, wear this, and compliance. And you always, if you're not that person, if you're not that guy, you're someone in your office who loves that kind of stuff. It's fun. It's comfortable. There's no drama. There's no trauma. And for someone who, I mean, I thought it was pretty darn good at compliance with headgears and elastics. This is so much easier. You won't have any trouble with this. And if you're even more concerned, when you go to the actual two-day course, there's a huge section where we talk about this. You'll have it down, and you're going to learn tips and tricks about compliance. And Healthy Start has all these other interactive tools that are proprietary just to Healthy Start that will get your compliance program up and running for everything. So anyways, we talked about 90% is doctor time, is staff time. But in addition, you're not seeing these patients every 4 weeks. You're seeing them based like a retainer patient. There's some active and there's some passive faces in there, and depending on what stage they're in, and again, we'll go over this in actual course, you may see them every 8 to 12 weeks. You may see them every 6 months. So those 4, 5, 6 years fly by really, really fast with very little time, very little supplies, very little overhead, very little cleanup. Super duper easy. All right, so what happens if you do nothing? You kind of know this party trick. You can take a look at a kid that's 2 and you can tell already if they're going to need braces. Doctors come up to you, friends come up to you all the time at parties. They're like, hey, you think my kid's going to need braces? It's a 2-year-old. You should be able to know. Obviously, we know crowding in primary teeth, bad. Even the perfect little chiclet teeth, the beautiful little model smile in primary teeth, bad. They're going to have crowding. Spacing equals good. Parents have a hard time understanding that, but you know that ideal amount of spacing, if you didn't know this, is 6 millimeters. Beyond that, they're going to have a little bit extra spacing. But all of this can be treated with the Healthy Start appliance system. When's the best time to start treatment? The best time to start treatment is before the permanent teeth come in, just when the teeth are getting wiggly. Couple exceptions to this, and again, we'll go over this in the actual course, but if they have a severely retrognathic mandible, you got to start a little bit early, or if they have habits. So these are some of the different appliances that we use, and the series and the selection is customized for the patient and all the modifications. And again, we'll go over this in the actual course. You can kind of see some of the stuff that's out there, and we'll go over the actual biomechanics of each appliance at the course. But Everything is BPA-free, silicone-free, removable, and we have our own little special compliance indicator system that's built in. So don't worry, you'll know if your patient's wearing the appliance. And the results are so dramatic, especially as they move up from the habit corrector to the actual appliances that straighten the teeth and use the EG, that if, you'll know if they're wearing them because it's fast. Let's go over some kind of outcomes, take a look at some results. There's some crowding cases. Now remember, we're not providing an external force, so the rate of movement and the rate of treatment is going to go at the own rate of the child. So first stage, first active stage is going to be from when they first start losing their teeth till 2 to 2 are in. And you know that can take time. So average patient, maybe taking about 30 months. And then after that, there's a lag period. And I know with my son, that lag period was about 2.5 years where they won't lose a single tooth. It's literally like same thing. And then all of a sudden they'll start losing them again. So we kind of have two active periods built in and a passive period. And during the active time, you may see the patient every 8 to 12 weeks approximately, and during the passive time, you may see them every 6 months. Spacing, same thing. This case took about 33 months to get to 2 to 2, and then they went into a passive. Overbites, we know overbites have to be treated. They always get worse. And overbites is one of those outliers, it's one of the exceptions I was telling you about, where they do occasionally need to wear their appliance at night. Class 3. So class 3 is a little bit tricky. We can only treat the dental or pseudoclass 3s. We can't treat the actual skeletal class 3s. It's important that you need to know how to diagnose that. Open bites, really easy, but not the skeletal open bites. Cross bites, yes, we can treat this, but if the cross bite is too severe, you'll need to use a Schwartz as an additional appliance, but that's usually only about 22% of the cases. And I know you know how to do that. Crowding. Here's some before and afters on crowding. You can see that. Overbite. Here's some before and afters. And when you go to the course, you'll see even more. I'm just gonna try to lightly touch on it today. Overjet. And treating overjet is tricky because it's a combination of not only dental age, but skeletal age. So, you know, growth needs to be on your side. If you don't know, I'm sure you know that there are 8-year-olds who are done growing. There are 17-year-olds who are still growing. I know y'all know that. So timing is key. Let's take a look at a few cases just real quick. So real quickly, here's a nice patient. He came in about 8 years old. And gosh, if this came into my office, I would have said, gosh, this is a surgery case. Or at best, maybe we can use some headgear. Phase 1, phase 3, by the way, that's $9,000. Well, no problem. Treated with the Healthy Part Start appliance system, no brackets and wires, nothing additional. Nice outcome. And I think this one photo on the bottom is kind of your in between your phase 1 and phase 2. Case 2, started age 5, great growth of the jaw. Great outcome. Again, I love it. And I love this picture in the lower right. Soft in class 1, looks fantastic. Remember, there was no brackets and wires. This was done entirely with the Healthy Start appliance system, which is removable and worn at night. And speaking of that, I can't tell you how many patients I had come in. You know, you guys have been there and you got to kind of laugh about it, where they're coming in for a consult and they're sitting down in the chair and they're asking, what can I do for you today? Oh, I want a retainer. Oh, great. Okay, well, retainers only retain the teeth, so that would keep exactly what you have now. Is that kind of what you're looking for? Oh, no, I want Invisalign. Okay, that's great. By the way, that will be X amount. Gosh, can I just have something I can wear only at night? No, Invisalign's worn during the day, and I don't want attachments. Well, this is a great, great option for someone who doesn't want anything bonded on their teeth, just wants to wear it at night. Where else can you get that and move teeth so dramatically and grow jaws and fix bites? So remember, everything that we're saying here today is based upon research, okay? So we have hundreds and hundreds of articles that we have published ourselves. We also have many other ones that support some of the features and functions that we use. We want to back up everything we're saying here today. So no, I'm not giving references to the bottom because it kind of detracts away from the message. But I do want you to take some time. If you have questions, email us. Anything that you want supported that I said today, email us at info@thehealthystart.com and we will send you the link to that article. Also, our most popular articles are on our website, www.thehealthystart.com. You can go to providers, you can go to research, and we kind of put our most popular articles up there. You can take a look at it. This is a great research here. Now, I think I told you that Healthy Start is kind of the fourth generation of the Ortho products, okay? So along the way, as it's evolved over the last 50 years, it's had some name changes because each new generation of the product incorporates the benefits of the product before it and kind of gets a new name. That's how they do it. So right now it's called the Healthy Start. The product before that was, I believe, is called Night Guide, and you'll see that here. Before that, Occlusal Guide. So a couple Ortho-tane, a couple other things. So you might see some of the research incorporating different names. It's all Healthy Start. Don't worry about that. But this is some great new research that came out basically showing that there's no change with the Healthy Start treatment to face height, no change to inherent growth pattern. It's really easy. Most patients are compliant, 93%. And again, we'll go over compliance and how to incorporate that. Much easier than you think. Takes a few weeks for the patient to become used to it. We'll go over that. But average takes about 3 weeks. Again, you want to under-promise and over-deliver. So tell your patients can take 4 to 5 weeks. Kind of go over what to expect the first night, the first few nights, and they get used to it. Be their cheerleader. Have that staff member who's there to support them. But there's no discomfort, so it should be pretty easy. It's just something different, right? It's like getting a new pair of shoes. So all this time we've been talking about EG and habits, but we didn't talk about maybe what you're here to learn. Most likely it's what most patients are here to learn. But I wouldn't do the product benefit if I didn't tell you about everything else it does. And these are things that no other appliance system does. We're talking about the systemic benefits. We're talking about the sleep benefits, the sleep disorder breathing benefits. So how do most orthodontics diagnose and treatment plan airway disorders in children? Well, I thought I had it totally down. I thought I had the science down. I thought I was amazing at it. You know, we all think we're great. What did I do? I totally looked at tonsils. I looked at TNAs. I looked at adenoids in the staff. I asked questions. I referred them to ENT. I used that really fun lifesaver trick that I know you all use that we learned in residency, and that's pretty much the only myofunctional tongue thrust trick that we use. Yeah, it doesn't really work. It does cause cavities, though. But that's pretty much what I did. But what was I not doing? A lot. Well, we're going to go ahead and move to this slide. And this slide is really to the key to our presentation. It's the key to why so many patients come to the Healthy Start treatment looking for providers all over the world. And we have pockets, just to let you know, of the United States especially, where we have patients ready to go. We're just looking for a nearby provider. So not a problem. So do consider that. It's kind of like I said, Invisalign was 20 years ago. No problem getting patients. So there's a lot of questions. There's a lot of symptoms here. I see about 20 of them. And you're thinking, like, what are these symptoms all about? What do these have to do with orthodontics? Well, it has everything to do with orthodontics. And if I'm going to blow your mind here, I'm going to tell you that all these symptoms are related to dentistry. All these symptoms are related to orthodontics. All these symptoms are related to occlusion. And in my opinion, all these symptoms are things that every single pediatric dentist, every single dentist, and every single orthodontist should be screening kids for. So if they're not in your medical history, add them in or start the conversation. But there should be red flags, just like we saw in those kids, our virtual consultation at the beginning of the program. There should be red flags. There should be red flags in the medical history if they filled it out accurately, and ask some additional questions. Once you know this information, you can't unknow it. You'll never, ever do a consult again with what you've learned today if the same way, if I've done my job right today, and that's what I'm hoping that I will. So let's move to symptom number two, the bedwetting. I know when I first saw this slide ages ago, when I first went to my first Healthy Start course, I was like, bedwetting? What the heck is she talking about? What does that have to do with orthodontics? I have nothing to do with that. Well, you have everything to do with that, and I'll explain why. But first, I'm going to tell you a little story about a patient of mine. Now, I'm purposely not giving you the patient's name. I'm purposely not showing you slides of the patient because this patient is still connected with me, and he knows I will talk about him in presentations because I think his message and my testimony about his message is something that's very powerful and can help people. And both providers and potential parents or potential patients. And for that reason, he's allowed me to share his story. But he doesn't want me to release any information because when you kind of dig into what I'm telling you, it's a little embarrassing. And now he's an older teen. So regular phase 1 patient came to me about 8 years old, nothing special. phase one habits patient. You can figure out what he looked like. So he presented with open bite, tongue thrust, constricted arches, history of habits, mouth breathing. He was class one. A little bit lip incompetence, speech issues. Sounds about right, right? So how did we treatment plan him? Okay, no biggie, probably the same way you do. Initially, we used a fixed expander and a 2x4 appliance. We did some myofunctional exercises, that darn lifesaver trick. Okay, I can tell you he was not compliant at all. He was not happy. He was not tolerating the treatment. So I had to take out the fixed appliance and replace it with the shorts with a tongue or thumb crib. Still not compliant, hating the whole treatment. He was one of those patients, I call him not it patients, and if there's parents on this webinar, which there may or may not be, please forgive me, but we have a sense of humor as orthodontists. We have not it patients, and I know your staff will say that, and if you don't know about it, your staff know about it. These are the patients that are on the schedule, and everyone goes, not it, 1, 2, 3, not it. You don't want to treat them. Jumping around, complaining, whining, refusing to sit still. The appointment that should take 20 minutes takes 2 hours. Throwing up during the impression, which is back when we took impressions. Not fun stuff. And I can tell you how much overhead I spent on his lab fees because I had to keep switching him out for other stuff because it was constant either intolerance. I think he had some sensory issues, everything like that. You know, I spent more than I probably took in less insurance and all that. It was ridiculous. But anyways, it was a learning opportunity. All right, I digress. So let me tell you a little bit about this kid's symptoms. The only reason I know about his symptoms, and I wouldn't have asked about this stuff, is because, you know, you're starting your practice, you're kind of new at it. You get to know the patients and parents very well, because often you're doing a lot of the adjustments, and also was a not it patient, so I got stuck doing a lot of the adjustments. But he pretty much suffered for every one of these symptoms from my memory on this list, except for maybe the delayed growth. I mean, I don't know. He seemed pretty big to me. What else? I would say, I think there was one about grades on here somewhere. His grades were pretty good at the time. Oh, difficulty in school. No, he was a good student. Private school, top straight A student, but really bright. Otherwise, he probably had an 18 out of 20 on here. He was out of control. Maybe the allergies. 17 out of 20. So, wow. You know, in hindsight, now that when I first sat through this presentation, I was thinking, oh my gosh, this reminds me of this patient, right? Okay, so long story short, fast forward 8 years, completely forgot about this patient until later we had reconnected and I said, hey, how's he doing? Well, oh, one thing I forgot to tell you. End of treatment, I debonded, and the mom said, hey, gosh, he's just a whole new kid. And the kid looked great after treatment. He looked great. He wasn't listening anymore. We totally corrected his occlusion. His listening went away. It looked like his mouth breathing had gone away. His tongue thrust had definitely gone away. He looked like $1 million. He talked like $1 million. He seemed happy. She said, thanks so much for the treatment. By the way, thanks so much for curing his bedwetting. I'm like, huh? You know, you're like, what? What'd you say? Did I do that? I didn't do that. Okay, whatever. Nice and great. Take your retainer to get case. Go, bye. But anyway, she explained to me that he was regularly bedwetting all the way through treatment, ever since he was a kid, went to all the urologists, they're talking best money could buy for treatment. No, none of these pediatric urologists could figure out what the heck was going wrong with this kid. And they didn't know. They said maybe he had outgrow it. He was wearing this electric underwear at night with this bell that would go off every time he wet the bed. First, he had pull-ups, of course, so it was 5 or 6, but then they stopped making him in his size. I think now they make him in all different sizes. But it was totally traumatic for the kid because he couldn't socialize. He was kind of a social recluse now because he couldn't go to slumber parties. He couldn't go on Boy Scout campouts, et cetera, et cetera. He was stuck at home with his parents, and he hated it. Couldn't travel. The parents hated it because this kid every night would wet the bed. The alarms would go off, and the kid would sleep like a rock. He never, ever woke up to the alarms. When he slept, he was almost like he was dead, they would say. You couldn't wake him up for any reason. I think once they were in, like, a hotel, and the fire alarm went off, and he was getting so heavy, they couldn't even pull him out of bed. You can't wake him up. That's a scary thing. So, like I said, long story short, the problem went away. Weird, interesting story. I couldn't figure it out, right? But coincidentally, it went away once we corrected the occlusion. So I'm thinking like, oh, I don't know. I have no idea why that happened, but okay, thanks for letting me know. Great, take your retainer, guys, go. So, all right, long story short, 8 years later, I did reconnect with them. I said, how is he doing? They said, gosh, you know, his teeth still look great. You know, and I'd given him some Viveras later. He was one of those patients that, very fortunate patients that had phase 1, but never ever needed the phase 2. You know, we created enough space. Everything came in nicely. So I gave him some Viveras, a set of four Viveras. He was good for life. He wears his Viveras every night. So occlusion looks great. Bite looks great. Teeth looks great. Smile looks great. Can't say anything. But they said, hey, the tongue thrust is back. The mouth breathing is back. And guess what? The sleep issues are back. Not the bedwetting, but everything else. So now on this list of symptoms, and I'm just having a verbal conversation over social media too, she's saying almost everything is back except the bedwetting, but now he's having difficulty in school. So he went from a straight A student at the most prestigious private school to a C D student at public school. He's so tired. He sleeps 13 hours a night, doesn't get out of bed, wakes up, has headaches, got to go back to bed. He's had all these blood tests. They're checking for lupus, chronic fatigue, mono, nothing wrong with him. He's completely fine. Everyone's blown away. I said, maybe you should go get a sleep study. You know, now the kid's almost an adult, so we're past the healthy start age. I said, you can go get a sleep study. Just go. And he's getting it next week. But in any case, long story short, yes, you can correct the occlusion, but if you do not eliminate all the habits permanently, it's going to come back and haunt you. It's going to come back and haunt the patient. Relapse may occur if they're not wearing retention, and they're not going to necessarily feel better for life. All right, so we said, we already addressed upon it, what's the root cause of the symptoms? Root cause of the symptoms is sleep-disordered breathing and sleep deprivation. So over the past 20 years, totally strong correlation. So I kind of think you kind of get the idea already how this works, but I'll recap on it. So let's start with something so innocuous as bottle feeding, passy use, poor tongue position, abnormal swallowing. Habits can later turn into bigger problems. We all know that all these things can contribute to the jaws being in the wrong position, constricted arches, tongue position being right, wrong, swallowing being wrong, cross bites, etc. Well, you may or may not know that when all this stuff happens, you have a compromised airway that can result. Not always, but in most cases. So you're going to have, in the body, reduced oxygen saturation levels and increased CO2 saturation levels, which is going to ultimately cause the body to go haywire. And kids are totally different from adults. And I know many of you understand sleep apnea in adults. Maybe you've taken courses. Maybe you haven't. It's big. I know at AAO it was back. It was very popular. We're starting to understand airway a little bit more and how orthodontics is related to it, about bringing teeth and jaws forward, not moving things back so that we have more space for the tongue, et cetera, et cetera. But kids are different than adults. Kids have to have their oxygen. They're growing. They need it even more than an adult does. Yes, an adult can have a junky night sleeping, maybe not so much oxygen, but you know, maybe it causes some stress on the heart, but ultimately they're gonna be okay the next day. They're gonna feel bad, but they'll be okay. Kids not only feel bad, but they may not be able to verbalize that they feel bad because they don't know what normal is all the time. But their body's not going to grow. Their body's not going to do what it needs to do. Like I call it, the body goes haywire. So the body's smart in kids. If it's only getting X amount of oxygen and it needs Y, it's going to route that most precious and valuable oxygen to the most life-sustaining organ systems, which is going to obviously be your circulatory system, your brain, so your neurological system, and your respiratory system, so the heart, the brain, and the lungs, right? Where is it not going to go? Well, it's not going to go to the immune system, our studies show, and it's not going to go to the bladder or the excretory system. So the first thing to go is you're going to get allergies, eczema, you're going to get hyper. You know, the kids get really, really hyper. Often they get ADHD kind of symptoms, and it actually can cause ADHD, and there's a 50% correlation in that. And also, they're going to just feel generally junky, and they're going to have bladder problems. So that's what happens. So like I said, once you hear this, once you know this, once you learn this, you can't unlearn it. So next time you have a patient in your chair, for any patient, for a consult, I don't care if they're 13 or 3, you start doing earlier treatment, ask the questions, incorporate some new questions. We do have an additional page that you can put on your consultations. It's called a sleep questionnaire. It's an additional 30 questions. It takes some time. You have to explain the why to the parents, why they need to really answer this information accurately. But it should help you get a better assessment. But also, when you see them marking things like allergies, they're on allergy medication, you see them marking different types of ADHD medication, just Strattera, whatever else, ask more questions, because maybe there's more going on than just an orthodontic problem. Maybe you can do more to help them. All right, so we kind of started talking about airway. Let's look at a regular five-year-old. We have a five-year-old on the left with a restricted airway, a five-year-old on the right with a normal airway. These are just two five-year-olds. And you know what? Anatomy can be different in every single patient. So not all five-year-olds alike. And you may not know just by looking at them, but usually the restricted airway is correlated with a retracted or a retreated mandible and some of the signs and symptoms we talked about before. So sometimes you can tell just by looking at them that they're more likely, they're more predisposed to having a restricted airway. So you can get this from any kind of your SEPs, and I know you're taking SEPs. Just take a look at the SEP. See the difference? We like to refer to our airways as either being coffee straws or smoothie straws or coffee straws or garden hoses. So that's kind of how we affectionately refer them to. We want everyone to be a garden hose. We don't want anyone to be a coffee straw. And if you've never breathed through a coffee straw before, please, please, please go to your local coffee shop. Go to your local gas station. No, you can't go to Starbucks because Starbucks doesn't have it. It's not environmentally friendly. You get your 1950s circa coffee straw and you breathe through it for a few minutes. Please, if you faint or pass out, don't put it on me, okay? Like I said, and all the opinions are not that of Healthy Start, they're of me. But in any case, you're gonna feel really bad breathing through a coffee straw for a few minutes, and you're only gonna do it for a few minutes. Think of how this kid feels all the time breathing through this. No wonder why they're not feeling well. No wonder why they're not acting well. No wonder why their grades aren't good. It's not their fault. But you as a doctor can make changes. Let's add on to that. Let's add on to that the effect of mouth breathing. Okay, on the left, regular, nice airway. We got a smoothie straw. We got a garden hose on the left. What happens when this patient is mouth breathing? This is just a simulation, just to show you. Even the garden hose, once you're mouth breathing, for whatever reason, I don't know if it's tonsils, I don't know if it's adenoids, I don't know if it's a stuffed up nose, whatever it is, if it's just tongue position, once you add on mouth breathing to that at nighttime, the normal garden hose is turning into a coffee straw. You probably never knew that, but now you do. We're back. We came back to our nice little kids. I promised you we'd be there. Now let's see if you see what I see. Take a few seconds. Make some notes. What about these kids? Okay, I'm going to tell you what I see. Number one, I see venous pooling under the eyes, both the eyes of these kids. Venous pooling means basically dark circles under the eyes. But it's, as you know, in adults, we cover it up with makeup. But in kids, it's quite obvious. And if you're seeing this on kids, maybe it's just one time. Maybe it's just an odd night. Maybe they came back from a slumber party. If you're seeing it routinely on the same kid over and over again, it's a problem. And it shows you that likely, whether they have allergies or they're suffering from sleep disorder breathing, they're not getting enough sleep. That's a concern. What else? I see dry lips on both of them. That's a sign of mouth breathing. I see lip incompetence on the one on the right, and I see a dolichocephalic profile, elongated face. All signs and symptoms of possible sleep disorder breathing. Both these patients are at risk. I would screen them further. What about these? I know you see the small lower jaws, okay? The retrognathic mandibles, that's obvious. What else do you see? Lip incompetence, yes. Mentalis strain, yes. So rolled lips, yes. All of these are signs of kids at risk. So I really want you to take the time, and if you're not able to do this, if you become a Healthy Start provider, bring your teams to the course. You can bring so many team members, bring them, because they will get as much out of it as you do in terms of screening patients, knowing what to look for, and encouraging these patients to come in for screenings for early orthodontics. Wow, we're already done today. I'm super excited that you stuck with me throughout this whole lecture. Hopefully you learned a ton. So thanks so much for listening to my presentation today. I hope you have a totally new appreciation and a desire to learn more about this innovative new system to treat children in your practice. Stay tuned for a few important announcements from Kathy telling you how you can become a provider. And take a look at this map right here. This shows you exactly where we're having courses this year. We're always adding them. And we'd love to come to your town. All right, Kathy, take it away.
Thank you so much, Amanda. What a great presentation. And I'll tell you that every time I'll have an opportunity to listen to what she has to allow, I'm impressed with how crisp, how concise, and how clear her message always is. And so with that, I'm going to take us to the next level here by sharing with you where you could go if you want to take it to the next level. And a presentation in person is the best. Without question, it is where everything just sparks, comes alive, and you really get a chance to meet the people from the company. A lot of people say, I can't believe I call and I can actually talk to your CEO. Yes, it is that kind of a company. Also, I would say that when you're there, you watch people kind of evolve into something where they recognize this isn't just something that's great for their practice. It's great for all the people in their family that they care about. They plant a flag and they take a position, like Dr. Wilson has taken a position in understanding all the things the appliances do. We had some questions come in. And speaking of appliances and the company, never heard an answer to either one of those areas that the person looking for information was unhappy with. They were always pleasantly surprised to know exactly what our company does, backs it up, and how everything is structured. They love knowing that if they step into this, that they have the opportunity to have Dr. Bergerson himself and a staff of orthodontists that are looking over all of the materials that you send in. So the guidance that you have is from people who have been doing this for a long time. You'll be able to kind of monitor yourself and see, well, this is what I think I would take forward as an approach, and then you'll compare it against the guidance that you're getting so that it's an ongoing education. So what you see here is the opportunity to take that step if you decide that's what you want to do. And Dr. Wilson was right. Amanda knows what it is to see an entire team just fire up on how many people in their practice, how many patients have presented these kinds of issues, but nobody knew. How many people are sleeping with a spouse that if their parents who had done everything they knew could have had this, what would you do if you could go back and change it? Those are the kinds of emotional connections that people have. And in this profession, that is a very, very big transition. So in order for you to get to be a part of our next gathering, whether it be online or if you want to bring your team and come to one of our events, there is a $500 reduced cost to you. And that's an appreciation for being with us today and getting a little bit more familiar with what we are doing. So that coupon can be redeemed by simply sending a quick email to Susie, who's driving the bus right now. She's technically behind the wheels here. So Susie@HealthyStartChild.com. She'll see that your name was on the list. And also, if you want to get the CE credits and everything, then you can definitely give us a call at 844-KID-HEALTHY. That's Kid Healthy. If you want to see the events, and by the way, this is going to be open. If you don't have an answer this minute, it's okay. By the end of the week, we're talking by the end of Friday. Right now, we have a number of doctors that are on internationally, and of course, it's recorded, so it could be replayed for members of the team that might not have been able to tune in over the last hour. But we want to say we're going to shut that $500 reduced cost down at the end of day on Friday. So let's say midnight Central Time. That would be where your clock expires, so definitely want to take note of that. I'm going to share with you some of the locations that we have events coming up. Right now, our team CEO and one of our lecturers is in Manila. They just presented to 850 doctors yesterday, and they are working towards doing something in conjunction with the Children's Hospital there and taking 200 children in a research project. These are the types of things that we're seeing in universities all over, including international. We were in Ecuador and spoke to both private and public dental schools, as well as the Ministry of Health. So this is something that I believe that there is a win around the table in every chair. When you go into your waiting room, it's not just the kids that are sitting in the seats, it's the ones crawling under them. And the referrals are wonderful because a parent will tell another parent, man, this is what we did, look at what's happening. And they're seeing the transition long before braces. Also, we've got doctors that have referrals now coming from chiropractors, from pediatricians, from ENTs, because now they have an answer on where to send these parents whose children are, struggling with these things. That if you put it off, if you wait, well, then they're going to go through life with just a diminished opportunity, Band-Aids, inefficient, costly. So when you're looking at this list, maybe take to heart the fact that this could really do something for your patients and really allow you to stand out in a community of a lot of other dentists. You're the one who would have the training, the team would be ready to go, and you have a planted flag saying this is where you can go to resolve all of the problems permanently, comprehensively, safely, non-pharmaceutically. It's just the perfect result any parent could hope for if only they knew. Which comes back to, once you know, you can't unknow. It happened for my grandchildren. That's why I'm here. That's why so many of us with Healthy Start are here with a passion, and it's to communicate this message. So take a look. We're going to be in Charlotte, San Jose, California, San Diego. Dr. Amanda Wilson, who you just learned from, is going to be there for that one in Toronto. So if you've got anyone in Canada, please alert them to this. Nobody has more credibility and influence than the doctors themselves, and we would love for you to be able to help us. The digital media world is helpful, but it's definitely an advantage when they're hearing from somebody who has exposure to and experience with what we're trying to accomplish. We're going to be in Charleston, South Carolina, Austin, Texas. Dr. Wilson will be with us. You notice that I've got a little star by Chicago? That's when Dr. Bergerson is going to be recognized. We're going to be doing an event there, a lecture there. But if ever there was a time to, you know, travel to Chicago, make it that week, meet this man. We're going to be in Ann Arbor, Michigan, which is going to be fabulous because we're going to do a great tailgating event. And I think that it's going to be a lot of fun for everybody. Columbus, Ohio, Greater New York Dental. And the fact that I include that is because I want you to know that if you don't see us at a lecture, it's probably because we've got a number of other events going on in other areas of the dental world. Kona is where Dr. Wilson will be. And also you can see that there is a patient day, as she mentioned. It's such a wonderful opportunity for you to meet a part of the community that you wouldn't have access to if not for this. And if you didn't get all of this, that's fine. Just go to thehealthystart.com. If you want to see where the events are coming, you can just go to providers. There's an event calendar. Rattle down that line. You'll find what you're looking for. But don't hesitate to call us. We are so anxious to be a part of what you're doing. We have practice integration specialists that are going to hold your hand and take you forward. And you will be a hero in so many families. What you can do to give parents the answers they're looking for. Just remarkable. So for now, I'd like to say again, thank you to Dr. Wilson, Dr. Amanda Wilson, our orthodontist who conducted our presentation and panel today, to Susie Lafredo, who is behind the scenes pushing the buttons, and I myself, Kathy Turner in communications for Healthy Start, is saying just have a healthy, happy day, and please incorporate this into your practice real soon. We look forward to working with you. Thank you all for being with us. Bye-bye now.